Good morning, Emerson. It is Friday morning. We have a great show for you today.
Matt, this isn't GME.
We're going to see what's been happening all around campus.
Yeah, that's better.
Because this is Common Agenda.
No, Matt.
It's Closing Time Live with Matt and Cassidy.
Seriously, what are you doing?
It's April Fool's Day.
Oh, great. It's going to be one of those shows. Well, is it all out of your system now?
Probably not. Lion's Den this is.
The Lady Lions are currently sitting at a 500 record of 8-8, but more importantly, they are 4-0 within the GNAC conference. The two best players offensively are Brittany Rochford and Shannon Tarosian, who are batting 354 and 400, respectively.
Jim Tan Laundry, GTL, does the Jersey Shore inadvertently promote health and fitness?
A little bit. It does promote working out, but it also promotes heavy drinking. These guys, very heavy drinkers. Look at them, they all look nice, they got the pecs and everything, but inside they have no livers.
Interesting fact, Lil Wayne is a huge advocate of steroids in professional
sports. Whoa, that doesn't surprise me.
Greetings, Earthlings. It is I, your Vatican assassin warlock leader, Charlie Sheen, aka Chuck Sheen, aka Carlos Estevez, aka Chaim Sheen, live here on the streets of the bitchin' city of Boston to talk to people about my upcoming film, Major League 3. Let's do this, epic.
Savannah Mosser, Alicia Pelagin, and Lacey Russell have been outstanding for the Lady Lions, and Mosser was named the GNAC Player of the Year. Behind some excellent leadership by Captain Kaylee Smith, the team outscored their opponent 77-24.
You know, it seems like half the news we get about athletes these days has more to do with their personal lives than with their athletic abilities.
Yeah, and all that talk has us wondering, who's got real game?
Yeah, well, how about Mark Sanchez? He's allegedly hooked up with a 17-year-old.
Yeah, that's just creepy. The guy could have anyone he wants, and he goes for a girl that's 7 years younger than he is. That's gross.
Float like a butterfly, sting like a bee. A little bit of Muhammad Ali, anyone? Such a legend. I've always wanted to try out boxing. Today, I get the chance to here at the Ring Boxing Club on Commonwealth Ave in Boston.
The Final Four is coming up this weekend, and then on Monday is the championship game. Number 11 VCU is taking on number 8 Butler in a very surprising Final Four matchup, and number 4 Kentucky, who just barely survived Princeton in their first round game, now they're going on to play number 3 UConn in the Final Four.
Hi, I'm Emily Enters reporting from Roch Field, where our girls softball team is hard at work practicing for their upcoming game against Emmanuel College.
I wouldn't really say I'm most involved with any one specific thing. I decided when I came here that I want to keep singing. I did that all through high school, so when I saw Noteworthy perform in the first 2 weeks I was here, I was like, I got to audition for them. Like, this is definitely something I can see myself doing.
But in the second half, the team began to struggle. The offense was only able to get 5 shots off on the goal, and UMass Boston took advantage of these misses.
Now to the NBA we go. The league is in works to buy the New Orleans Hornets. Hornets owner George Shin has agreed to sell the club. Shin is citing financial trouble. The league will look to see if they can keep the franchise in New Orleans and keep star player Chris Paul at the same time.
Coach Craig Letourneau, who built the men's program 3 years ago, has recently announced that he will be leaving Emerson College at the end of the year.
Yep, he won Coach of the Year for the women's volleyball team last season. He'll be missed, but unfortunately, that is all the time we have for today's show.
All the time we have for the show, but make sure to follow us on Twitter at EC Lions Den for updates and scores.
If you tweeted us, your thoughts may even end up on the show. How awesome is that?
See you next time, guys.